Good morning, everybody. Thanks for joining me. Today, I wanted to talk about the chi clock, or the 24-hour meridian clock that we have. It's a feature of Chinese medicine, Chinese medical theory. We use it to diagnose and we use it to treat. It can be very useful. And like everything in Chinese theory, it's not 100%, it's approximate. So, but it's cute. First of all, I just want to explain something about Chinese medicine vis-a-vis Western medicine, which I call emergency medicine. When you learn emergency medicine, you start at the bottom. It's like a pyramid. You learn basic chemistry, basic anatomy, basic physiology, basic biology, all these basic classes, right? Then the next level is a little more complicated, right? Bio energy and physical chemistry and so on. And then a next level of intricacy and so on until you get to your focus, your specialty. Chinese medicine isn't like that. Chinese medicine is more like a pie. And here you can see a pie chart. So you have to learn this piece, and then you learn that piece, and then you learn that piece, and then you learn that piece, and all the while you're going, I don't get it. That's the way it was for me in medical school. I said, I don't get this during the first year. Okay, you learn this, you learn that, you learn that. And then finally, I remember that one day, I don't know, suddenly I learned a new piece, and boom, it all fit together. It's like Indiana Jones putting the key in the lock, and the whole thing lights up, and the door opens, right? So, and that blue section, that's the theory, by the way, because that's the most important part. That's the part that I like to talk about. That's the part I taught for many years, Chinese medical theory. And the clock, qi clock, meridian clock, is part of that theory. Now, qi, which moves everything and activates everything, it runs through your body, and it runs through up and down and into all of your extremities and all your organs thousands of times a day. It's just going constantly, moving and moving and moving. And it moves along channels, or meridians. We have 14 major meridians. We have a meridian going up the midline and down the back of the midline. But the other 12 meridians are on this clock. Right? And the qi is moving through those constantly. And there are three sets of fours, we would say, that it goes from the head all the way down to the feet, back up to the extremity, to the hands and feet and back. That's a whole circuit. So three of those circuits will equal one whole revolution, and that happens a thousand times a day. Well, it kind of runs along a clock, a 24-hour clock. So during a certain two-hour period of that 24-hour clock, qi will resonate, whatever that means, resonate its strongest. It comes to the surface during those 2 hours. And if there are problems in those organs, they will show up during that time, very likely. And also, those organs are used, they're useful during those times. So you can diagnose. You can also access the qi with acupuncture and acupressure easier during those times. And the same thing, 12 hours opposite too. So that's also like a tide. You know, a tide will affect the earth in two different spots, right? At the spot closest to the moon and the spot furthest away from the moon. It's the same thing here. So let's go through that clock, very interesting clock, as you can see here. Let's start with the morning. When you get up in the morning, what do we have? Actually, before you get up, we have lungs. So now, if you've got a problem in the lungs, that phlegm is going to lay down and cover the whole surface, one whole surface of the lungs. When you're upright like this, it's down here at the bottom. But when you lay flat, it covers half of that surface, making it difficult to breathe. So by the time 3 to 5 roll along, you're coughing. So people who are coughing 3 to 5, that's probably when you're going to cough. That's probably when you're going to have a hard time if you have a lung problem. Okay, so, and then right after that is large intestine. Now we'll see that lung and large intestine are connected. They're connected through the metal element. And we see a lot of problems where the two are associated. Amazingly, there's a connection between lung and large intestine in many ways. Well, large intestine here a lot of people, myself included, during that time, let's see, from 5 to 7 in the morning, we'll have our first bowel movement. Yeah, between that time, get up, move around a little bit, the chi gets moving, the large intestine becomes, the chi resonates in that channel and organ, and consequently we need to go to the bathroom at that time. If there are problems in the large intestine, like pain or bleeding or something, they'll probably show up then. And if you have a large intestine problem, you want to schedule with your acupuncturist to go in and see him or her between 5 and 7 in the morning. You're not going to do it. But you can do it 5 and 7 at night, you see, opposite, right? You get better effect. You get a better result that way, okay? So that's lung and large intestine, middle element. Then we switch to the stomach. And the stomach, of course, that's the earth element. That holds the food or the drink that you first consume. And so it's grinding, it's receiving it. If there are stomach problems, you're probably going to feel it, you know, at that time, early in the morning, 7 to 9 a.m., right? Now, daylight saving time, I don't know. We don't, you know, 2,000 years ago, they didn't have daylight saving time. So you just, this is all approximate. It's all approximate, right? Right, so that's stomach. And connected, of course, and the other organ channel in the earth element is spleen. This is, of course, your Chinese spleen, not your Western spleen. Chinese spleen is kind of like the pancreas. It's your major digestive organ. And that is going to really start processing not only the, because your chi is moving, your metabolism is going. It's going to continue processing the food you ate the night before and anything that you just now consumed. So if you have a major digestive problem, and show up then, and if you need it treated, that's when you need acupuncture. That's when it will do the most good. So that's spleen, that's stomach spleen, late morning. And then from 11 to 1, we go to heart. And this is when a lot of people have heart attacks. Well, of course, this is when you're working the hardest, right? Your heart is pumping, it's going, it's really cranking out, it's moving a lot of blood and chi. Well, if there's a problem, because it's the middle of the day, and your chi is really active. And of course, it resonates strongest in the heart channel, heart meridian, and the heart organ at that time. So this is when a lot of heart attacks happen too. If there's a blockage, it could show up at that time. If there's chest pain, it could show up between 11 a.m. and 1 p.m. All right, so that's something to pay attention to. And it's a good time to treat it too. Connected with that, oddly enough, you may wonder why, it's a small intestine. Small intestine is that fire element. Heart and small intestine are fire element. All I can say is that at that time, your small intestine has finally received the food that you may have eaten in the morning or at noon, and it's processing it, right? There are connections between heart and small intestine. We call it heart fire. But you get into that when you study pathology. So there are definite pathological connections between heart and small intestine. That's 1 and 3 a.m., right? And then connected to that, then it goes to the bladder. The urinary bladder, 3 to 5 p.m. If you have bladder problems, probably will show up at that time. It just does. And that's a good time to treat bladder problems, 3 to 5 p.m. And connected to that, of course, in the water element, is kidney. Now, kidney is your longevity energy, of course, and so if you're really worn out during that day, you'd probably be flagging at the end of the day between 5 and 7. If you've really pushed it, if you've hurried and worried and worked really hard and overworked, and you might have a low back pain too. That's kidney as well. That's that water element. The end of the day, you'll probably be fatigued. If you're having anything like that, that's a good time to get it treated, like back pain. Mm-hmm. 5 to 7 p.m., good time for that. Now, connected to that is another two channels that are fire element. They're the minor fire element. The major fire element or channel organs are, of course, heart. This is the pericardium. And the pericardium is just the covering around the heart, but it is a fire element, and that heat can build up throughout the day and really start to cause some problems like chest pain and heartburn or chest pain at that time from 7 to 9. And then of course it goes on from 9 to 11. That's Sanjiao, that's triple burner. That refers to the upper burner, middle burner, lower burner in terms of water metabolism. So your water may slow way down in the evening between 9 and 11. You may have swollen feet, swollen extremities, may have trouble with water moving at that time. Then related to that, the chi moves on to the gallbladder, which is the wood element. It's oddly enough, gallstone attacks, gallbladder problems tend to happen between 11 p.m. and 1 a.m. Surprise, surprise. We're not surprised, but because the chi resonates in that channel at that time. So that's 11 to 1. And related to that, of course, is its wood element partner, liver. That's your Chinese liver, of course, not your Western liver. And there, if you have been carrying a lot of anger, frustration during the day, it may show up in your liver channel from 1 to 3 a.m. and you may have trouble sleeping. Yeah, because that heat disrupts the heart. It disturbs it. So your shin is out wandering around because of all that liver heat. So that's what we see. That's the clock. And then, of course, it goes on to back to the lung and just continues on and on and on like that. So that's a brief rundown on the chi clock, on the 24-hour meridian clock. Thanks for watching. Have a good time. Have a good day. Stay safe during this corona epidemic, and I'll see you next time.